Hi guys, Yasmo here. I've had a few people ask me about Diamond Flask and how it works. There is some confusion about the Diamond Flask and I want to explain a little bit. It's not that complicated, but people still are not sure about when is it best to use Diamond Flask, when is it more effective. And basically there are some graphs going around that are showing it from like a weird perspective, so it's hard to tell. Basically, your critical strike chance is lucky, means that you will perform two rolls instead of a one, and it will take the better one if one of them succeeds, right? So let's say your chance to crit is 10%, then it will basically roll once, and basically the engine will perform like a, you know, will pick a random number between 1 and 100, right, let's say. And if it's 1 to 10, then you will crit. If it's not, then you will not. But if you're using Diamond Flask, then it will do it again. And if you crit at the first time or the second time, then it will count as a crit. So it gives you basically two rolls. And the way it affects your actual percentage, like your actual chance, is you can see it here in this kind of a spreadsheet that I found. This is accurate. This shows you that if you have 5% base crit, then with a Diamond Flask you're gonna have like 9.75, so it almost doubles it. Once you get, like, the higher you go, the lower percentage of your crit you're getting, but the higher flat amount you're getting. Meaning if you are at 5%, the Diamond Flask will give you 4.75. If you're 6, it will give you 5.64. So the higher you go, the higher it gives you until you reach 50%. 50% is the breakpoint where it is most effective. So let me use my wonderful paint skills and show you what it actually means. So that means 50% is the highest effectiveness, right? So this is at 50%. And then this works basically like this, right? So imagine this is the highest point at 50%, and imagine I painted it correctly. When you have 0% chance, obviously the flask will give you 0. When you have 100%, obviously it also will give you 0, because you're critting every single time. And so here you're getting 25% crit at this level, right? Because if you have 50% crit, then half of the time you will crit, and the other half of the time you have again half of the time to crit. So it's 25%, right? So it's 50 plus 25, right? Because at basically 50% chance and another 50% chance, that is 75% chance to crit, as you can see here, right? 50%, it gives you exactly 25%. Once you get higher, then it diminishes. So if your crit chance, let's say you're using power charges, sorry, wrong window. Let's say you're using power charges, and with power charges, while you're running around, you have around 50% crit chance. Let's say it's 40 something or up to 60, then this is perfect. Yeah, the crit flask will benefit you so much. It's going to be amazing for you. But if you are at, like, you know, below 20% crit or above 80% crit, I think that's the point where you might want to look into another flask, because it will not give you that much unless your crit multi is really, really high. So you also want to take into account your crit multi, because if your crit multi is really, really high, then each percentage of crit chance is more impactful in terms of your damage, right? But if you assume the same crit multi in every case, then of course it is the best at 50%. So hopefully that explains it. And this is the same, for example, I guess there's only one unique flask, Coralito, right? Coralito is the only other flask that is works exactly like this, right? There are some other lucky effects. So lucky basically means lucky basically means rolls twice, right, and picks the best result. That's how it works. So that's how Diamond Flask works. Hopefully this stops the confusion about how it works. If you are about 50% crit, it's the best to use, and then the closer to 0 or the closer to 100, then the effectiveness of that flask diminishes. Thank you guys for watching, and see you next time.